Evolution. It keeps us growing and transforming.
Adapting to the constantly changing world, the story of Enactus SRCC has always been about evolution.
The evolution of our projects, our communities, and the evolution of ourselves.
We now present Project Virasat.
Virasat, the Indian word for legacy, is to millions of Indians the intangible cultural heritage that gets passed from generation to generation. The craft sector, which spans over 19,000 craft forms, is the vivid painting of beauty and diversity.
However, the torchbearers of this legacy have been reduced to faceless laborers. With mechanization and industrialization, the fear of losing their identity looms large over these craftsmen.
To bring back the lost glory of India's craft forms, we started Project Virasat.
The first step of our endeavor began with the Thathiar community of Jandiala Guru, a small village in the golden city of Amritsar. Thatheras are a community of skilled craftsmen known for making handmade brass and copper utensils by hammering.
In 2014, the Thathiar craft of Jandiala Guru was the first and the only craft from India to be inscribed on the UNESCO's list of intangible cultural heritage.
Despite this international recognition, the community was plagued with challenges such as internal conflicts amongst the Thatheras, outdated products, and lack of access to markets due to exploitative middlemen.
With the help of the district administration of Amritsar, we unified our Thatheras into a self-help group named Punjabi Thathera Art Legacy, abbreviated as PITHAL. In 2018, Project Virasat was launched by the Cultural and Tourism Minister of Punjab, Mr. Navjot Singh Sidhu.
The next challenge we faced in the upliftment of the Thatheras was the traditional products they made, which did not align with the contemporary market. To solve this, we collaborated with professional designers and came up with 65 new designs.
Displaying the PITHAL products in three cities in 2018, the Thankar of the Thatheras now echoes throughout the country. This year, we successfully marked our presence in 14 retail outlets and 20 exhibitions, with our products now also retailing in the international airports of Mumbai and Amritsar. We were also invited by the Italian and Swedish embassies to display the legacy of our Thatheras.
Riding the wave of e-commerce, we listed PITHAL products on more than 6 websites, along with rebranding our website PITHAL.in. PITHAL also obtained its very own import-export code and is now catering to orders in more than 13 countries.
This year, we saw tremendous growth, with our revenues crossing over 41 lakh rupees as the income of our Thatheras grew by more than 500%. To ensure sustainability of PITHAL, Harpreet and Tarish, the children of our Thatheras, now carry forward their legacy as they completely manage the operations of their enterprise.
To ensure safe working conditions in Jandiala Guru, we provided them with hearing aids and safety equipment. We also partnered with professional architects to design efficient workplaces for our Thatheras.
Welcoming the craftsmen from Indore and Chandni Chowk, we extended our Virasat family from 11 craftsmen in 2018 to 23 this year. Joginder, a Thathera from Indore who had left back his craft in search of better employment, came back to continue his legacy.
नमस्कार, मैं जोगिंदर सूरी बोल रहा हूँ. मैं पहले जंडाला गुरु में था, तब मैं इंदौर में आ गया हूँ. श्री राम कॉलेज वालों ने दिल्ली से स्टूडेंट ने मुझे सहयोग किया, जिससे कि मैं अपने काम में लगा हुआ हूँ. और इंदौर में 21 परिवार और हैं खटेरे जो साथ मिलकर चलना चाहते.
With Project Virasat, the hammer strokes of our Thatheras have now become the impressions of opportunity, growth and dignity.
In 2019, Project Virasat opened a new chapter to revive another dying craft form of this country, the miniature paintings of Udaipur. A craft long forgotten in the bustling city was touched by our endeavor. As we evolved, we flawlessly blended the historic art of miniature paintings with the Thathiar craft of Jandiala Guru.
Vancouver Land Machine for quite some time. The efforts of actors have now come up as entrepreneurs and are doing extremely well. They have also brought in different art forms like the Tateras and the miniature painting of Udaipur. And together, a synergy has been created. And just I see a prototype for an excellent model for developing any community of arts persons and craft persons. And it will be a good role model for the country and even abroad.
Project Virasat was started as a journey to revive the legacy of India.
And this journey does not end when we step in the lives of these craftsmen, but when our craftsmen step out of their shells, transform from laborers to proud business owners once again.
दुनिया में आपने हमें बिल्कुल ऊपर उठा लिया और हमने भी आपको उठाया. और क्या ये बच्चे मेरी विरासत हैं, आप भी मेरी विरासत हैं. ये कल को यही काम करें, हमारे बाद तो यही हमारी विरासत होगी ना.
We now present Project Azba.
Anand Parvat, a transit camp in West Delhi, wakes up to fights over a single bucket of water, queues stretching across for countless miles, and floods of people leaping onto each other as the tanker enters. Getting clean drinking water is a battle that they fight, but don't win every day. Similar is the situation with 163 million people in our country.
To strike the problem at its roots, we started Project Azba with an aim to provide clean drinking water in urban slums and rural households by setting up water filtration plants.
We begin with identifying areas and conducting comprehensive need assessment surveys. The raw water is then sent for testing in certified laboratories. Based on the contamination in water, we deploy a suitable filtration technology with the help of our technology advisors.
Each of our community filtration plants provide water to 550 families at an unimaginable price of 4 rupees for 20 litres.
The cost of setting up a plant is rupees 10 lakhs. We collaborate with the government to ensure that resources are efficiently utilized to bring down our costs by 50%. Our advertising partner, Tata Steel, finances the outer structure, reducing our costs even further.
This year, we entered into an innovative financial model with Delta Pure Water India Limited. We now pay a monthly rent of rupees 10,500, and after 20 months of operation, the ownership of the plant is completely transferred to us. This means we do not have to incur an initial capital expenditure, and every plant we set up can buy itself out with its own revenue.
Once the plant is set, we identify two previously unemployed women to operate the plant. To cultivate true entrepreneurship, our operators earn 20% of the surplus in addition to their fixed salary. Last month, Sulekha Didi, one of our oldest entrepreneurs, earned an income of 8,500 rupees.
Hello, my name is Sulekha. I'm
App was introduced for systematic data integration and making projections for the optimal utilization of our plants. To ensure sustainability of our model, we established the Azba Trust, enabling centralization of operations and transparency.
This year brought into light the grave water situation faced by the Indian villages. In the wake of such extreme conditions, Azba expanded its horizons by successfully setting up water filtration plants in the backward areas of Mewat and Pitlokar. Recognizing our efforts, Project Azba has been made the central implementing agency by the governments of Haryana and Muzaffarnagar.
Not only restricting ourselves to providing clean drinking water, we step towards conservation of water following a two-pronged approach. Reuse and reduce. The wastewater generated from our plants is routed to a nearby toilet complex and a recharge well to replenish the groundwater. This year, we identified new technologies which reduce wastewater generation to just 1%. Aligning ourselves with the Jal Shakti Abhiyan, we are now in the process of setting up rainwater harvesting systems in our areas.
Starting with just one plant in 2018, Azba has now grown to 9 plants across 3 states, dispensing 90,000 litres of clean drinking water every single day.
But we did not stop here. Capitalizing on our existing infrastructure, remaining surplus and widespread network, we formed synergic collaborations to enable a multi-fold impact in our urban slums.
We collaborated with the Nanhe Pakshi NGO to promote education for children in our areas by setting up community libraries.
In collaboration with Project Bala, associated with Enactus Warwick, we successfully distributed reusable sanitary pads to 1700 women, with our plants being used as selling points. Project Asba has been lauded by the Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi and the former President of India, Pranab Mukherjee.
Born in the narrow streets of Lal Bagh, Project Asba has now become a water revolution.
A revolution empowering 18 women,
reducing health expenditure by more than 72%,
and quenching the thirst of more than 26,000 people every day.
Tum hamare bacche ho, jo bhi karoge, hamare liye achha hi karoge.
We believe we are harbingers of hope
in redefining India,
with our communities being our true heroes.
As catalysts of change, we seek,
we create,
we strive,
we empower.
We are Enactus SRCC.
Thank you so much, team. We will now begin with the question and answer session. Only the judges may ask the questions. Please raise your hands and we'll provide you with the microphones.
Hi, thank you for your presentation. My question is, I'd like to understand, how did you zero down to the Thatheras? There are many other art forms which are there which face similar fate. So what went into that zeroing in?
Thank you so much for your question, sir. So in 2014, the Thatiyar craft of Jindiala Guru was listed under the UNESCO's list of intangible cultural heritage. Agreed that there are 19,000 dyeing craft forms of India, but when we visited the village, we identified so many problems, and yet there was so much of talent and potential in all the Thatiras and the craftsmen. So after our extensive need assessment surveys, we zeroed down to the Thatiras, but also that there are Thatiras community pan India, and now we want to work with all of them eventually.
For this Thatira, I think these are handmade things, right? So these are generally costlier than the machine made things. So how are you thinking to compete in the market with this handmade, and what is the niche target segment?
Thank you for your question, sir. So yes, handmade products are slightly expensive than machine-made products, but because the craft form has an international recognition by UNESCO, that is a very like a promotional story for all the customers. Apart from that, the premium quality and the exceptional designs that our Thatiras are making, it cannot match the machine-made products, because that is replication. But because handmade products comes with customization, so the prices, then our margins increase.
Hi, I have a question for Project Virasat, which is that, are you currently managing the project? So what is the plan for, you know, sustainability of the project?
Thank you so much for the question, ma'am. For the demand side sustainability, we have established 14 retail outlets and listed our products on 6 websites. This ensures a sustainable source of income for our craftsmen. When it comes to the supply side, we're very proud to inform that now the children of Thatiras completely manage the operations, from the finances to inventory to the order taking and the logistics. Along with this, we've created an SAG which takes care of the financial inclusion and the transparency aspect. With this, the trainer trainee model will be followed to integrate more Thatiras of other regions. And lastly, because we've created a prototype, this will help us replicate the model in many other craft forms, 19,000 which are in this country, because all the problems in the craft sector are very similar.
Excuse me, I want to ask about the creating demand for Project Virasat, we're creating awareness. Perhaps there is not so much awareness about these kind of products. You created a production facility. Have you done anything for the creating demand for these products?
Thank you for your question, sir. So apart from the exceptional designs, the utility that our products offer, brass and copper also have immense health benefits, especially copper. It's very good for your skin and your mobility. So, and apart from that, brass is known for its exceptional health benefits for cooking. So because of this health consciousness in customers, it has increased our demand avenues even more.
So your report talks about reduction of waste and reconstruction of sewer system as impact from an environmental side. We didn't see that in your presentation.
Sorry, sir, could you repeat your question?
So your report talks about an environmental impact of reduction of waste and reconstruction of sewage system in Project Virasat. We didn't hear about it in your presentation.
Thank you so much for the question, sir. So the environmental aspect of Project Virasat comes in when we visited these craftsmen, we learned to know that they worked in dingy cells, and while smelting the metals, there used to be tremendous amounts of smoke that was produced in these dingy cells. With the construction of smokeless chimneys, we were able to reduce the pollution content. And for the sewage system treatment, there have been narrowing down by the government, and they've been able to construct a separate sewage system which ensures cleanliness in the area.
Thank you.
How do you give comfort in terms of the buyers that this is an authentic product, because you're talking about a UNESCO heritage, then is there a way to certify that is an authentic product?
Thank you so much for your question, sir. So each of our artisans have been given an artisan card by the government of India, and that acts as a suitable way for us to authenticate to our customers that these products are in fact handmade by artisans from Jandala Guru.
Sorry, your time has now expired. Judges, please join me in thanking Enactus Sriram College of Commerce for their presentation and hard work.